So how do we do recognition? Well, actually, it's pretty straightforward. I have some new novel X comes in, some new novel face image, all right? All I do is I project it into the subspace. What does that mean? Just like before, I subtract off the means and I compute the dot product, the coefficients, W1 through WK. By the way, I can then do something that's optional to put here. Suppose I'm not really sure that what you gave me was a face image. Well, what I can do is I could reconstruct using those coefficients, and now here's the thing. If you gave me some other 10,000 dimensional vector, right? You know, three guys on a bicycle. And I try to make that image by just summing up 100 eigenvectors from the face space, how well do you think I can reconstruct that image? Not so well. The only images I can reconstruct well are faces. So I could do the reconstruction and compare them and say, aha, bad choice. This is not a face image. It also means, by the way, if I'm looking for faces in a picture, I might do that. In fact, in the original Turk and Penland, they actually did detection that way. There are now better ways to just detect raw faces, but the ability to reconstruct is a way of knowing that, yep, I actually have what I was looking for. I'm going to use to see if I can reconstruct to do some tracking, but hang on, that's for the next lecture. But for the recognition part, it's optional. Let's assume it really is a face. Well, then all we can do is we can say, all right, you gave me these W's, right, 1 through K. Let me find in my list the one that's closest in of those K numbers. I might use a Euclidean distance, some other distance metric. But basically, I have a description of a new face coming in, and I just see which of the descriptions in my database is closest. And that's why you can think of this somewhat as a generative model. There's actually more detail to use it in a more probabilistic way. We'll actually talk a little bit about that in the tracking. But the idea is that each one of these descriptions gives me a probability, if you will, or a likelihood of what this person's face might look like, because it assumes that this has captured most of the variation and that the other stuff doesn't matter too much. And if a new one comes in, I can just compare them. And if I get closer, that's more likely. And that's why it's a generative model.